Blastpop here. Today I'm looking at yet another of the MMP series, ex-gamers. This time it's an SCS game of Panzer Battles, which is part of the standard combat series, which, for those who may not be familiar, is a series that utilizes some basic wargaming concepts and does so in a way that creates some fairly interesting battles. Battles that can range from World War I up to the Arab-Israeli wars, because they are that adaptable. Usually they have a low counter count for the most part, but they emphasize great and interesting battles, and just have a good appeal to the beer and pretzels wargamers, as well as those looking for a good solid game. This arrived in the mail today to me, and so I just open it up here as best I can, see what's inside. Okay. The inside, we have a content listing of what's in the game. Two dice. We have rules for the standard combat series, Panzer Battles, which is the actual special rules for this game. And typical of these games are fairly basic rule books, which are adequate to the task, but you know, they lack in modern day presentation, but they're adequate to the task, no doubt. No complaints here. Well, I tend to prefer to have setup charts for games, especially with setups in many different hexes, or when you don't have free setups in the games. And the difference with this one from the rest of the standard combat series is that you have a chit activation system. And apparently, when you pull the chits, those units can either move in combat as needed. Also, you have standard rules here, and let's see, nothing out of the ordinary. Zones of control, combat rules, advance after combat, reinforcements. All stuff that most wargamers most likely will be familiar with. This includes two maps. Now, this takes place during the winter of 1942 to 43. And so the map does have a look of winter with the white background. And cold looking features. So it does tend to capture that feel quite a bit. Got gullies and streams. There's two maps. So this is a big game. But there aren't many counters. There's something like 280 counters in this game, including markers and combat pieces, so the density, for the most part, is going to be pretty low. It's going to be almost like a North Africa situation, where you have a few forces, open flanks, and a great deal of desperate combat. Anyway, I can't open all these maps up, but this certainly gives you an idea of the quality of the maps, as well as the content. Finally, and last but not least, are the units. I have one immediate concern, and I'm sure others may see the same thing as I. If you take a look at the units, some of the combat values are white with a black drop shadow to show them. Now, I don't know about you guys, but I'm not getting any younger. And from a distance, these could be a lot more harder to read than those that are printed with a black print. I'm sure they have the reasons why, but usability is fairly important too, so that's one thing that could register as something that I have some reservations about. So, in the back of the counter sheet is your reduced or eliminated sides for those that units that don't have more than one step. Interestingly, the units look to be battalions. Some focus here. Companies. So these are fairly small units. So relatively a few groups of a few men in some cases. Overall, very nice. Classic Eastern Front Panzer Battles. Battle of the Chur River Line. That's pretty interesting. And the designer on this is Dionysic. Always a great designer. Published by MMP under the Gamer's line. And hope you enjoy the video. Like it if you found this useful or enjoyable. Thank you. Hope to see you soon. Bye.